In a world riddled with war and hate, there was hope. Hope for an abused and neglected species, the hermit crab.
You see, there are millions of uneducated hermit crabs out in the world, and they don't have any money because they can't get real jobs. They're stuck doing hard labor because, you know, they're not smart enough to do anything else. So they wind up homeless, shellless, no one likes them because they think they're just stupid. Hermit crabs, they need these rights. They need to be able to go to school and get an education, or else they're just gonna keep being the pits of society.
Dying crabs, because the Bible says they're going to hell.
I just really think the people that are this in love with hermit crabs just don't deserve to live.
They're sinners.
Sinners.
I hate you.
I'm actually a crab myself.
For years and years, the species was ignored and underprivileged. They were uneducated, which led to high unemployment within the hermit crab community. The market value of shells dropped dramatically. Many shells were foreclosed on, and hermit crabs were forced to vacate their homes. However, with the help of lobbyists and interest groups such as Humans Helping Hermits and People for the Education of Crustaceans, hermit crabs got more and more attention. After considerable struggle and substantial debate, Congress reached a conclusion. In 2005, they passed the Equal Education for All Species Act, also known as EEFASA, or EFASA. EFASA granted the right to a public education to most species formerly known as subordinates to humans, or more commonly referred to by a much more degrading term, pets. The only species not included in the act is the chinchilla. Since the bill was passed, living conditions have improved greatly for hermit crabs. You are about to see firsthand the experience of one young hermit crab. His full name is Ringling Rasputin El Tirano, but we just call him Raspy. And this is a day in the life of a hermit crab.
God. I'm really getting tired of taking you to school. This is the last time I'm going to do this. You better start catching the bus on time and start listening when I tell you it is time to get to the bus stop. You got it? Are you even listening to me?
They don't talk at all, really. They just kind of move around. They don't listen. I guess they probably get made fun of a lot in school. I'm sure people don't like them that much.
They're delicious, delectable, need to be eaten, not schooled.
Hey, can I borrow this paintbrush?
Well, Rasputin certainly causes no classroom disruptions, certainly one of our quieter students. That, in part, is some of the problem. I mean, I really like to see more involvement in class discussions. Really, participation is key to really being successful. I want to make sure that he's really got it when we're talking about the lessons.
Ignore it.
Ignore it.
Hope it goes away. I want to be sure I'm clear on this. I just want to begin to explain this now. There was, I won't go so far as to say it was ignoring it. Certainly accepting that the problem exists.
It's a great student in terms of not causing disruptions, but again, just like to see more participation.
But of a young woman's back. Her name was Betty Grable.
Not a problem, you know, he kind of paid attention, didn't really say a whole lot.
First one's always easy. We're at 0-0. What's that top coordinate going to be?
I don't know.
Caleb, what do we get?
Is it power or four?
Good.
Good kid.
This work is terrible. You get an F. In your face. It's horrible. I can hardly read it. Your penmanship is disgusting. That's right, you crawl away.
That new kid? He's pretty cute. I mean, he seems kind of shy. Like, I feel kind of bad for him because nobody talks to him and stuff. We know it's because he's shy. It's okay, he can open up to me.
You need to explain yourself. I got a call from school today. Heard you got into a fight. Pass this to Ras, please. I said pass, not slide it. Mom, he's a hermit crab. He's still your brother. We'll be right back.